Okay, this is a little video tutorial, basic video tutorial for a song called Rockin' Down the Highway. It's an old Doobie Brothers song. Came out in the mid-1970s off the Vices and Habits album. It's definitely a song, if you're going to play it, I mean, you can fake it all you want to, you know, you can find little ways around it, but if you're going to do this song in a band setting, you really need two guitar players, and you need a really good bass player, a bass player that can really put a lot of, you know, fills in there and really knows how to stick them licks in there. It's good to have a really good drummer too, because there's a lot of tightness going on. They had a percussionist as well, and a keyboard player kind of fills it up, but this song is not one of their keyboard heavy songs, piano. It's not a Michael McDonald song. So it's heavy on the guitar. It's a rock song. There is a tuning. I saw a video on YouTube of a guy who was doing a tutorial on this song, and he actually, it's some kind of open A tuning, I do believe. But I'm just doing this in standard tuning. You can get away with it in standard tuning. It sounds kind of funny on acoustic guitar. I'm just doing this so you can see how to play the song. On an electric with some overdrive going and a little bit of reverb, it sounds all right. But if you want to look up the video where the guy's showing the tuning and everything to get it exactly right, you can. I'm getting away with it fine, even on stage playing with a band, just playing it in standard tuning, standard A440. What you're going to do is you come up here to the 11th fret, and you're going to bar straight across the last four strings, bottom four strings, and you're going to take your pinky finger, and you're going to do the same thing except for only the last three strings, but you're three frets up, 11th, 12th, 14th fret, and you're going to let the A ring out, because the song is in A. Hit it twice, and you're going to bring that whole thing down two frets. Hit it two more times and then let off your pinky, and then move down to the fifth fret, and you're going to do an F, open chord F shape, except you're going to come up here, let it ring out, and there's a little bass run in there. That's why I'm saying you really need a good bass player to get away with this song. There's a little bass run. Okay, now you've got a little note run here that's also in A. This is the one of the guitars and probably the piano and the bass together, and there's some drum licks in there, toms. D string, second fret. Come up here to that's the G string, second fret. Then you go to the D string, fourth fret. And then you bring the G string back down to the second fret. And then you go up the A string, fourth fret. And then open. Let's do that again. The song actually ends like that too. Then you're going to have the guitar by itself. Just keeping that A going, ring the A out, little hammer on there, fourth fret of the A string, and then he's hammering on again up on the fourth fret of the D string. It's just straight down picking. Flat picking or kind of angled picking works really good with this little riff here. And then when he gets into the verse, it's a straight up blues type lick. And then you're going to throw in an A with a D bass there, or A bass with a D note added. Got those highway blues, can't you hear the motor running? goes straight back. When you come off of that D, you're going straight back to that little blues thing. And you go to an F. And you're going to come up to an E. And a one little run there from the D sharp E. You go up here to a, this is a G, F, G, I'm sorry, G. And you just got one fret to go up back to that little riff there. Okay, at the end of the song, he comes up here and he's playing, this is an F sharp. 7th. You don't want to play it up here because it's too ballsy sounding. You need to play it up here. And then you're going to a C sharp, I do believe. Yeah, C sharp. And then a B. And he goes up to an E. Back to that little blues lick. And the guitar solo keeps going from there. It goes to the verse again and back up to the chorus. And they start singing again. But anyway, again, this is a song. It's not super complex, but there's a lot of instruments involved, and it sounds best if you've got two guitar players, a really good bass player, a nice tight drummer who can throw a lot of fills in, and a percussionist, because there's a lot of percussion in there as well. Okay, there you go.